Most days, Dave Millican is working in his garage, setting metal plates onto leather belts. By his own admission, it can be tedious and time-consuming. But there are not many people who do what he does.
What I do is what I call an oddball occupation.
When he's finished, Millican's belts will be seen by the more than 4 million people who watch pro wrestling on TV every Monday night.
I make belts for the biggest companies and collectors all over the world. Of course, my biggest customer is WWE.
For the last 6 years, Millican has been working with WWE to provide championship belts for larger-than-life stars like John Cena and The Rock.
Most of the belts on WWE television are mine, from the WWE title, the World Heavyweight Championship Big Gold Belt, the Intercontinental title, the tag team titles.
Millican grew up in the 1970s, just outside of Memphis, Tennessee, where wrestling legend Jerry the King Lawler reigned supreme.
We had a few channels, not much else to do, and wrestling was a huge thing. So wanting to have something to kind of bragging rights with my buddies and stuff, the only way for me to have a championship belt was to make one, so that's what I did.
His first belt was as basic as it gets.
When I started making belts, I was making them out of cardboard when I was 13 years old.
As he got older, Millican never lost the itch to make title belts.
I was in the Army. I worked in corrections for 5 years. And all this time, I'm doing belts on the side.
Now Millican makes belts not only for WWE, but for smaller wrestling and mixed martial arts companies and avid collectors from around the world. And as it turns out, the belt-making business is pretty lucrative.
I would say we probably turn out between 60 and 70 belts a year. I send belts all over the states. I do a lot of business in Canada and Japan with collectors.
Millican also spends a lot of time refurbishing old belts. After all, in pro wrestling, belts are bashed into foreheads about as often as they're worn.
I still cringe when I see something, especially if it's a brand new belt, something that I've just sent to one of the companies, and I see it being used as a weapon or taking a really bad spill onto a concrete floor. But then I have to remind myself that that's actually job security for me, because the more of them they tear up, the more of them that I'm making.
Jason Sanchez, CNN Money, Tony, Alabama.